Welcome back to my channel. So, what is the most important step in a hair care routine? Yes, it is oiling. So, there are a lot of myths rotating around about this oiling. So, let us break all of them in this video. See, I'm not going to start off listing all the benefits for oiling because there are n number of advantages and I can't list one by one here. And I'm pretty sure all of you know already about this. So, let's just directly get into how to do this oiling in a right way. So the first step is combing your hair before oiling. This is very important because oiling itself creates tangles in your hair. So if you don't remove these tangles prior to oiling, this will create much more pressure on your hair follicles, which is not healthy. So the next step is using warm oil. Warming your oil before applying it onto your scalp helps for easy penetration and also nourishes and strengthens your hair follicles. So the next tip is about application. Firstly, use your fingertips and not nails because nails can damage your scalp. And then use circular motions with a gentle pressure so that the oil which you have applied will go into your scalp directly. The next tip is about how much time should we keep this oil onto our scalp. Basically, it is 4 hours minimum and maximum is 7 to 8 hours. If it exceeds 24 hours of time range, then it is not at all healthy and it ultimately leads to hair fall because the oil present on your scalp attracts dirt which clogs the pores. So it directly leads to hair fall. The next step is about how many times should we oil per week. It totally depends upon what your scalp type is. So firstly, oily scalp, you have to oil only once a week. And then coming to normal scalp, you can oil 2 times a week. And then lastly, dry scalp, you can oil 3 times a week. The next thing is the oil which reduces hair fall. So there is an oil called Jaburandi hair oil. You can mix with your other oils and apply under your scalp to reduce hair fall. So a lot of you are in a dilemma that if you are suffering from dandruff, you shouldn't apply oil. And this is a total myth because oil actually reduces your dandruff. Oils like rosemary oil and also tea tree oil, if applied along with carrier oil, will reduce your dandruff. So we have spoken about rosemary, tea tree and all these essential oils. So how to use this? Add 3 drops of any essential oil, it may be tea tree oil or even rosemary oil, to 1 tablespoon of carrier oil like almond or coconut oil and apply it onto your scalp. Please don't use any essential oils directly onto your scalp without diluting it with carrier oils. This will eventually lead to hair fall, so please don't do that. So this tip is especially for postpartum hair loss. For this you can add rosemary oil, it may be about 3 drops into almond oil and then gently massage it onto your scalp. This will reduce hair loss. So one more myth is applying lots of oil to your ends will reduce your split ends or even give you shinier hair. See, if you are applying lots of oil, then you will require lots of shampoo to remove this oil. That means you will require lots of chemicals to remove this oil, which is not at all healthy and it will ultimately lead to split ends or dry hair. So please don't apply that much of oil to your ends. It is a dead part. The live part is your hair roots. So apply more oil onto your scalp. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you have got a little bit of clarity about oiling through this video. If you did, don't forget to give this video a big, big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. It would really make my day. By saying that, I'll take your leave. Eat healthy and stay healthy. I'll see you next time. Bye.